Aynen. We were learning about the factors influencing the enol content. So we have seen the presence of active methylene group, how it affects. Okay, see any group that increases the acidity of active methylene hydrogen atoms increases the enol content. Okay, so any group, whatever the group, if it can increase the acidity of active methylene, any group, if it can increase the acidity of active methylene, then it can increase the enol content of that substance. See, there are several groups, so many groups are there. So most some important groups we will learn. See the order of groups which increase the enol content. First of all, we'll see acetone. So when compared to acetone, the ester group, if it is attached to, so this is called as active methylene group. What is active methylene group? Active methylene group is the methylene group which is present between the two carbonyl carbons. Okay. See, when compared to acetone, okay, here acetone is a simple ketone. Always simple ketones. They will try to exist only in enol, sorry, they will try to exist only in keto form. Okay, because simple ketones, they are stable in keto form only. They are unstable in enol form. Suppose that means when compared to acetone, esters, see this part is said to be ester, COOR. Ester means COOR. So this is called as ester group. So here, so this is active methylene group. So to this active methylene group, this part is called as ester. When esters are attached to the active methylene group of acetone, what happens? So the enol content, the acidity of this hydrogen is increased. Okay, the acidity of hydrogen is increased due to the attachment of ester group to this one. Okay, right. Next, when compared to the ester group, if a compound contains phenyl and ester both, that means here, so this is active methylene group, and if this compound contains phenyl group attached and also the ester group attached. Okay, if a compound contains in the compound, if the active methylene group is present, and in that compound, if phenyl group is attached to the carbonyl and even ester group is also present, then in that case, so it will increase the acidity of active methylene hydrogens to more extent when compared to the presence of esters attached to the active methylene group. Okay, so that means when compared to this one, in this compound, enol content is more, and when compared to this one, in this compound, enol content is still more. When compared to this compound, so here this in this compound, the enol content is still more. Here, what is this one? This is called as ketone group. Okay, acetone. When compared to ester, esters are attached. Esters will increase the acidity of the active methylene group. When compared to esters, phenyl and ester, the combination of both will further increase. And when compared to this one, ketone group, if it is attached to active methylene, so this is called as ketone group. If it is attached to active methylene, it is still, I mean, it will, it is further, it further increases the acidity when compared to the this type of compound. Okay, aldehyde, if the aldehyde group, this is called an aldehyde group, if aldehyde group is attached to the active methylene group, okay, then it is still, I mean, it is a best suitable example for the high enol content substance. So this is the I mean, here aldehyde will increase the acidity of the active methionine group to the larger extent, so that when compared to keto form, the enol form will be more stable. Hence, the compound will exist in enol form in more percentage of enol form when compared to the keto form. Okay, so like this. So this is the order. So this order is important. So we have to practice that order. And one more order I will give you. So in different books you will find different things. So just I will give you even that order also. Remember, aldehydes will cause more high enol content. Okay, aldehyde will cause high enol content. So this is what, this is aldehyde group and this is also aldehyde group. See here, actually this is hydrogen, this is also hydrogen. So it will, the percentage of enol will be more in this compound. The percentage of enol will be more. So how much? 99% of the enol will be present in this compound. Okay, this compound will exist 99% in the enol form only, not in keto form. So here I given this keto form of that substance, but it will convert into 99% of this compound will convert into enol form only. Okay, so next one is if instead of hydrogen, if two phenyl groups are there, so this is one phenyl group, this is another phenyl group. See, phenyl groups will extend their conjugation, so that when conjugation is extended, what happens? The enol content will increase. So when compared to this one, this is in this compound, the enol content will be more. So here two aldehyde groups are present. Okay. So to this methylene, so two aldehyde groups, CHO and CHO. Hence, the percentage of enol will be more in this case. Okay. Than this one. So, this will be more. When ketone is present, so this is carbon, this is carbon, this is carbon, carbon, carbon. Okay, so to this methyl group, so here both both side ketone is present, but here aldehyde is present. So this is CHO, but here CH3. To this C, it is O. CH3CO. Okay. So that means when compared to this, here two aldehydes are attached to this active methylene group, but here two ketones are attached to active methylene group. So that means here, in this case, the compound will be turn into more enol form. Okay. So here only 76% of the compound. Will convert into enol form. So the remaining 24% will be in keto form only. Okay. Next, suppose if alkoxy group is attached. So this is what? This is ester. So this is ester group. COOR, ester group. Okay, so this ester group, it is somewhat less. When ester group is attached to the active methylene group, so the percentage of enol will be less when compared to the attachment of keto group to the active methylene group. So here it is drastically decreased. Okay, here it is drastically decreased. It is only 8.4%. Okay, this structure is said to be एसिटो एसिटिक एस्टर, एसिटो एसिटिक एस्टर, ओके सी एच थ्री सी ओ सी एच टू सी ओ ओ सी टू एच फाइव. Okay, see only 8.4% of that I mean this this contains only 8.4% of enol. See now here, this is what diethyl melanoate. This diethyl melanoate. Melanoate, or else melonate ester. So it here only very less percentage of enol is present. 7.7 into 10 to the power of minus 3%. So like this, this is the order where enol enol content it varies. Okay, so like this that means different groups will affect the acidity of active methylene groups in different ways. Okay, now we will learn about the second factor. What is the second factor? Aromatic nature, aromaticity, how aromaticity will influence the enol content. Aromaticity. What is aromaticity? Aromaticity is nothing but if a compound, a compound is said to be aromatic in nature. So if it possesses certain characteristics, what are those characteristics? So the first one is it should be cyclic. The compound should be cyclic in nature. Okay. And the compound should be planar. So if a cyclic substance to be planar, so here all the carbon should be sp2 hybridized carbon are necessary. sp2 hybridized carbons are necessary. Okay, and these sp2 hybridized carbons, they should be in conjugation. Okay, they should be in conjugation. So conjugated structure. What is the meaning of conjugated structure? Conjugated structure means conjugation. What is that? See, a single bond, double bond, single bond, double bond, single bond, double bond. So such type of continuous arrangement of alternate single bond and double bond, or else a lone pair, single bond, double bond, single bond, double bond, like that, or else lone pair, single bond, okay, lone pair. So like this, so alternately if two lone pairs are arranged are present, then also it is said to be conjugated structure. So mainly in most of the cases we will see such structure. Okay, so if a compound possesses these are the very important characteristics of a compound to be aromatic. Okay, that compound should to be an aromatic. So these are another most important characteristic there. What is that one? Presence of 4n plus 2 pi electrons. 4n plus 2 pi electrons are necessary. So if all these if all the four set of characteristics are present, then only that compound is said to be aromatic in nature. For example, benzene. If you take benzene, so benzene, actually the formula of benzene is C6H6. It is a cyclic structure, and all carbons, it is a planar structure. All carbons undergo sp2 hybridized carbons, and a conjugated system is present: double bond, single bond, double bond, single bond, and 4n plus 2 pi electrons. So here, if n, what is this n? N may be 0 or 1 or 2, like that. Okay, so suppose if here one ring is there, hence n is equal to 1. If n is equal to 1, then how many pi electrons will be altogether? 4 into 1 plus 2, that means 6 pi electrons. 6 pi electrons are necessary. Let us count whether 6 pi electrons are there or not in benzene ring. So this is a pi bond. So one pi electron, another pi electron. So altogether, how many pi electrons are there? 6 pi electrons are there. Hence, this property, this property is satisfied. This property, and even all these four properties are satisfied. Hence, the benzene is said to be aromatic compound. Okay. Suppose here phenol. For phenols, the aromaticity, if a phenol is having aromatic structure, then if enol is having aromatic structure, then then that enol will be more stable form, and hence that compound will try to exist in enol form only. Hence the enol percentage will be more. Okay, aromaticity will increase the enol percentage of the compound. Okay, right. See, few points we will learn about aromaticity. Introduction of aromaticity it stabilizes the enol content. Stabilizes the enol to a larger extent than keto form. Okay. Which makes phenols? Which makes phenols to exist? Phenol is a, it's an enol. Which makes phenol to exist almost? To exist almost 100%. Okay, almost 100% in enol form. See, phenol, what is phenol? So this is said to be phenol. So this phenol, this substance will exist in enol form only. What is its keto form? Its keto form will be like this. So but that phenol, it does not convert into keto form. It will try to exist almost 100% in enol form only. See, resonance energy of benzene is it is most important. Resonance energy of benzene is 36 kilocalories. 36 kilocalories per mole. Okay, so this is important. So because of high resonance energy of benzene, what happens? So this structure will be more stable. Okay, see, look here. For example, if I take any such structure like this, a compound. So this compound, it's a keto form of the compound. What happened? So this keto form of the compound will try to convert into enol form. So like this, see, look here. So what is this one? This is sp2 hybridized carbon. Even this is also sp2 hybridized carbon. So here, though it is having a hydrogen atom, that hydrogen atom, it is not utilized by this carbonyl group. Okay, because this is not acidic, this cannot be acidic hydrogen. That means though it is alpha carbon, but this hydrogen cannot be utilized for the formation of enol. Even this hydrogen is also not utilized because these two are sp2 hybridized hydrogens attached to sp2 hybridized carbon. See, for the formation of tautomerism, hydrogen which is attached to sp3 hybridized carbon is necessary. See, here this is the hydrogen which is attached to sp3. So this carbon is a sp3 carbon because it is having two hydrogens. Two bonds are with two carbons and two hydrogens are present. So this is sp3 hybridized carbon. So now this hydrogen will detach from this carbon. This bond is broken and it will removed as H+ ion, and as a result of this one, this carbon gets a negative charge. This carbon gets negative charge. What happens? So now this will undergo rearrangement. So this will undergo resonance. So here the negative charge means here this carbon is having a lone pair of electrons. So that lone pair of electrons, or is this negative charge, so it forms a pi bond here. Okay, so this pi bond will shift here. Now this pi bond will move to this oxygen. So what happens? So this pi bond will move to the oxygen in the form of a lone pair. Okay, in the form of a lone pair. So that is why oxygen will get negative charge. Okay, see, this negative charge is disappeared because, so this negative charge is utilized for the formation of pi bond between these two carbons. This pi bond is shifted to here. That means between these here, it is shifted to here. Okay, now. And already this pi bond is present like this, as it is only. So this hydrogen, so I am not representing this hydrogen, okay, because this hydrogen is attached to that one only. So this carbon is having one hydrogen. See, this hydrogen which has lost, so now it will attack this one, and finally it forms what? OH. So in this way, this compound, okay. In this way, this compound will finally convert into phenol. Like this, it will convert into phenol. So this is keto form, and this is this is enol form. So enol form is more stable when compared to keto form. Because why it is more stable? Because in phenol there is aromaticity, but in this form there is no aromaticity. Though conjugation is present, double bond, single bond, double bond, okay, double bond, single bond, double bond, and here the conjugation is not present after this one. So conjugation is not extended. So two single bonds are there. Hence conjugation will end up to here only. But in this structure, डबल बॉन्ड सिंगल बॉन्ड डबल बॉन्ड सिंगल बॉन्ड डबल बॉन्ड सिंगल बॉन्ड लोन पेयर. सो ऑन ऑक्सीजन देर आर लोन पेयर्स आर देर. सो इवन लोन पेयर ऑल्सो विल इन्वॉल्व इन कॉन्जुगेशन. लोन पेयर सिंगल बॉन्ड डबल बॉन्ड सिंगल बॉन्ड डबल बॉन्ड सिंगल बॉन्ड डबल बॉन्ड सिंगल बॉन्ड. ओके सो लाइक दिस. So like this, here it is having complete large amount more that means large amount of conjugation when compared to this one. Hence this is more stable. Okay, phenol is more stable and it is having 4n plus 2 pi electrons. This is having only how many pi electrons? Only 4n pi electrons, and the conjugation is present. Okay, so when compared to this one, here it is aromatic. Hence it is more stable. So aromaticity, as aromatic nature is present in the phenol, okay, when compared to keto form, so the enol content is more in phenol. Okay, so like this we can explain. One more compound. See the compound here it is. It is a compound which is present in keto form. Okay, this compound will convert into enol form because in enol form it is more stable. Hence, it will convert into enol form. So like this. That means this hydrogen will shift to here, and that bonds are arranged. So rearrangement of the bonds takes place. So this bond will move here. This bond will move here, this bond will move here, and negative charge is developed there. So here, because this bond is moved, so hydrogen is free now in the form of it forms, or else it converts into H plus, and this H plus will attack here and converts into this structure. So in this also, the phenol is 100%. I mean the enol content is 100%, and this is very less percent, almost 100%. Almost nearly approximately equal to 100%, and this is unstable form, so it will immediately convert into this form. Even in the previous case also, even in this case also, even in this case also, what happens? So the phenol, it will convert into this will convert into phenol form. So here the compound, this is enol form and this is keto form. So 100% of this compound will be nearly approximately 100% of this compound will be in enol form only. Okay. So this compound will exist nearly 100% in enol form. This compound also will exist nearly 100% in enol form. Okay. There are some other compounds where 100% of enol forms are present. For example, here even this compound also, even this compound also will tautomerize. It is a keto form. It will tautomerize. Here the hydrogen which is present on this, so it will shift here. And double bond will come here, okay, so that it forms a phenol. So that it forms phenol. So 100% of the compound, even this compound also will exist in the form of this one. So indirectly, I can say that this phenol, it is in tautomerism with this type of compound and even with this type of compound also. So these three are said to be tautomers to each other. This one, and this one are said to be tautomers. Okay. So these two are tautomers of phenol. This one and this one are tautomers of phenol. Right. Next. Suppose if it is like this. There is one double bond. There is no double bond here. There is one double bond, and here there is a there are two bonds. There are two double bonds. There are two double bonds. So here, this one upon undergoing tautomerization. See, these three are in keto forms. So they will convert into enol forms. So after how it converts into enol form? See, already this hydrogen. This hydrogen will attack this one. Okay, this bond will move here. This bond will move here, and oxygen will become negative, and hydrogen will attack there. So finally, it converts into this structure OH. This one will convert here. This hydrogen, this is sp2 hybridized carbon related hydrogen. Even here also hydrogen is present, but preferably this hydrogen will move to oxygen, because here this hydrogen is attached to sp3 hybridized carbon. Okay, so when compared to this hydrogen, so this hydrogen will move. Okay, though it is alpha hydrogen, but still it does not involve in tautomerism. So the for the involvement of tautomerism, hydrogen in tautomerism, that hydrogen should be alpha hydrogen, and it should be preferably sp3 hybridized carbon related hydrogen. Okay, so that means this hydrogen will move. So as a result of this one, so already double bond is there. Okay, and here what happens, this bond already between carbon and hydrogen, this will move here and this will move here. So as a result of this one, what happens? So it forms negative ion. Okay, because this bond has shifted here, a lone pair is developed here. So this hydrogen is separated. Okay, this hydrogen is separated. So altogether I'm drawing this one as a single structure. So like this, it finally forms like this. This structure, this keto form will convert into enol form like this. Here, this structure will convert into enol form, and here, this structure will convert into enol form in this fashion. See here, in which case the conjugation is more. So here, lone pair, single bond, double bond. Here, lone pair, double bond, lone pair, single bond, double bond, single bond, double bond. Here, lone pair, single bond, double bond, single bond, double bond, single bond, double bond. So here more extent of conjugation, large amount of conjugation is there. Hence, this form is more stable when compared to this form, and this is this compound is more stable when compared to this one. So that means here in this compound, so the percentage of enol will be more when compared to the compound, this compound in which the percentage of enol will be somewhat less when compared to this compound. Okay, so enol content will be in the order. So here it is more, very, very much more when compared to this one, and this is more when compared to this one. So enol content order. So because this is aromatic, as it is aromatic, so it contains high, very large extent of enol content. So introduction of aromaticity stabilizes the enol to a larger extent than keto form. Okay, so which makes phenols to exist almost 100%. Okay, that means 100%, this is 100% of the compound. This compound will be in this form only. So here, when compared to this one, this compound have more enol content. When compared to this one, this compound is very very having very very more enol content, because here it is aromatic. This is not aromatic. So here only partial conjugation is there. Here complete conjugation, and it is 4n plus 2 pi electrons. Okay, and it is planar. So all the characteristics of aromatic nature are present in this phenol. Hence, 100% of the compound will be in enol form only. Okay, see. So what is the meaning of this one? So this the meaning of this one is, as conjugation increases, the enol content increases. As conjugation increases, even this also will says that as conjugation increases, the enol content of the compound increases. Okay, because the stability increases. So as conjugation increases, the enol content increases. What is the reason? Because when conjugation is increased, the stability increases. When stability of the enol increases, what happens? That enol will enol form is more stable, and that compound will try to exist in enol form only. Okay, right. Next, what is the next topic? The next topic is related to bridgehead. So this is the second factor, and the third factor is bridgehead factor. Bridgehead. Bridgehead carbon. See, if alpha hydrogen, if alpha hydrogen is present on bridgehead carbon, okay, then that hydrogen do not involve, that hydrogen do not involve in tautomerism. In tautomerism. Okay, in tautomerism. The bridgehead carbon cannot have a double bond. Double bond. If the ring size, this is important. If the ring size is less than 8 atoms, if the ring size is less than 8 atoms, then the bridgehead carbon cannot have a double bond. That means the bridgehead carbon does not lose the alpha hydrogen. It's an alpha hydrogen. Suppose according to this statement, so we will understand this statement with an example. Suppose this is a compound. Okay. This is a compound. And here, this is a carbon. double bond is there to this carbon. That means this is keto group, ketone group. Okay, so keto group is present here. So these two are said to be bridge head carbons. This is a bicyclic compounds. So bicyclic compounds are of two types: bridged bicyclic compounds and fused bicyclic compounds. What is the difference between bridged bicyclic compound, fused bicyclic compound? Suppose if two rings are joined by only two carbon atoms, okay, then such a compound is said to be fused bicyclic compound. Fused bicyclic compound. when two rings are joined by three carbon atoms, that means more than two carbon atoms, that means between two bridged carbon, if there is at least one carbon atom, okay. So here between two bridged carbon atoms, there is no carbon atom. But here in this case, between the two bridged carbon atoms, there is at least one carbon atom, or else at least one atom. Such compounds are said to be bridged bicyclic compounds. Okay. So here in this case bridged carbons, and even here also these compounds are said to be bridged carbon atoms. Okay, so this explanation is applicable to both of them. Suppose here, so now this is keto group, and this carbon is said to be bridged carbon, and this is alpha carbon also, and even this is also bridged carbon and alpha carbon. So that means here this carbon is acting as alpha carbon and bridged carbon. So that means here the hydrogen which is present here, it is said to be alpha hydrogen. If alpha hydrogen is present on bridged carbon, then that hydrogen do not involve in tautomerism. So that means this hydrogen does not involve in tautomerism. Okay, because if this hydrogen moves here, what happens? So the double bond will move here. So that finally it should form like this. Double bond is shifted, the double bond is developed between these two carbons, and here it forms OH. Okay, it is unstable because here this carbon now before that this carbon was sp3 hybridized carbon. Why? Because this carbon is having 1, 2, 3, 4 single bonds, hence it is sp3 hybridized carbon. So if this hydrogen undergo tautomerism, then it will convert into this structure. Now the bridgehead carbon has converted into sp2 carbon. Before that, this bridgehead carbon was sp3 carbon. Okay, now the thing is that sp2 carbon should be planar. Always sp2 carbon should be planar. But here, depending upon the ring size, the planarity will be. Suppose if the ring size is less than 8 atoms, then carbon cannot show planar. It cannot become planar. As it cannot become planar, what happens? It becomes unstable, highly unstable. Okay, it becomes highly unstable. Why it does not become planar? Because it suffers a large amount of strain. Because Here sp3, what is the bond angle in sp3? 109. 109 is converted into, it should be converted into 120. 109 should be converted into 120. Okay, so here sp3 is 109 degrees 28 minutes, and here it should be for planar it should be 120. So here during the conversion of this structure into this structure, there is a large change in the bond angle. Okay, there is a larger change in bond angle. So, this carbon cannot accommodate that much change. Okay, hence it becomes stable. Hence it becomes unstable. Suppose if there are 8 carbons in the larger ring. So, for example, if this is a compound like this. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, like this. So now this is there is 8 member long ring of 8 member atoms. So in this case, suppose if ketone is present on this, let us take the structure in this form. If ketone is present on this carbon, so now this carbon is bridgehead as well as alpha carbon. Even this also bridgehead as well as alpha carbon. So now as there are at least eight members in the ring, what happens? The strain which is felt by this carbon, it will distribute to all the atoms. Okay, it will here what happens? So now it is sp3 hybridized carbon, because hydrogen is attached. So now it is sp3 hybridized carbon. So now this sp3 hybridized carbon, as it is sp3 hybridized carbon, and it as it is alpha carbon, and it is having more number of as it is having at least 8 number of atoms in the largest ring, what happens? This hydrogen is ready to undergo tautomerism, and what happens? This hydrogen will move here and attach it to oxygen. Okay, now this the double bond which is present between oxygen and this carbon will move here like this. Now what happened? Now this carbon, before that it was sp3 carbon, now it has converted into sp2 carbon. Now it has become sp2 carbon. Okay, because double bond is there on this carbon, hence it is a planar. So that means before that its angle was this much, now its angle has become 120. Okay, there is a large decrease in the angle, large change in the angle. So in order to because all the surrounding atoms, what happens, this carbon atom will distribute some of its strain to all other carbon atoms, so that what happens, it will come into plane. Before that it was not in plane. So what happens, if large number of atoms are present, then what happens, slowly that carbon will come into planar with other carbon atoms. Before that it was like this. Okay, now what happens? So it will come into, it can extend its angle. Okay, by sharing its strain to the other atoms, so that it finally will convert into planar carbon. Okay, so like this. So under what conditions this carbon can convert into planar carbon? Only provided that when the largest ring contains at least 8 atoms. Unless until the largest ring contains 8 atoms, then that carbon cannot convert into planar carbon. Okay, easily. Okay, so like this. So this rule is said to be Bretts rule. This is called as Bretts rule, B-R-E-D-T-S. Bretts rule. That rule is called as Brett's rule. Brett's rule says that bridgehead carbon cannot have a double bond if ring size is less than 8 carbons. Okay, if ring size is less than 8 carbons, so that bridgehead carbon cannot have double bond. So in this case, what is the largest ring size? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 only. Hence, this bridgehead carbon cannot take this double bond. That means here this compound cannot convert into this compound. So conversion of this compound into this compound does not take place. That means this one does not show tautomerism. But here this compound, it was like this before. Now what happened? So it has converted into, it's a tautomer. Okay, enol form. So now the enol form will be stable form, because there is no strain on the carbon. There is no strain on the sp2 carbon. So what happened? As there is no strain, here double bond can be easily formed between this carbon, and on this carbon, OH is present. So now it is enol. So it is stable form. Okay, when compared to this one, this is stable form. Hence, what happens? So here bridgehead carbon. So bridgehead carbon, the nature of bridgehead carbon also will show some effect on the enol content. So here, if the bridgehead carbon to form into sp2 carbon, from sp3 carbon to sp2 carbon, so it the bridgehead carbon should be the part of at least 8 member ring. At least 8 member ring should be present for this carbon to convert from sp3 carbon to sp2 carbon. Okay, so like this, if it converts into sp2 carbon, okay, then it will become stable. But here it cannot convert into sp2 carbon because it is unstable, because that strain cannot be distributed with a little number of atoms. So for the carbon to distribute its strain, it requires at least 8 number of carbon atoms. Strain, okay, right. So now we learn the next factor. So what is the next factor? Next factor is rings. So we will learn about the rings in the next class, next video.